31. Samyam on the gullet or the hollow of the throat ceases hunger and thirst. This I have actually experienced. It's a little bit difficult, not very easy. But just close your eyes and here you just focus on this place. Take a deep breath, inhale slowly, exhale. Just focus on this place and don't use it every time because you don't want to starve every time. But by focusing there, you can forget your hunger and thirst. It does not mean that the body will not need food. But sometime when you don't have food for a few hours, for 3, 4 hours, 5 hours, 1 day, 2 days. Well, I did it for 49 days. But don't follow me. Don't follow me because I damaged my intestine a bit. Don't follow me, but yes, you can do it. You can ease the hunger and thirst. 32. Samyam on the Karma Nadi, one of the nadis or pathways of prana, sometime related with artery and veins, named Karma or tortoise, brings about stability or firmness. Let me tell you, whatever people's imagination of this Karma Nadi, nobody has really known for sure what is Karma Nadi. He is referring to a particular artery or vein. It can be artery, it can be vein. If you can focus on Karma Nadi, then you can have stability or firmness. But we have created a meditation. Actually, I was inspired by my guru. We have created a meditation because this Karma Nadi, this artery, this vein, whatever it is very specific. Whatever it is related with your heart. So we have created a meditation which we give here in mind culturing, where we rub our heart. So that is covering all the nadis there. Definitely Karma Nadi is part of that. So by rubbing your heart, massaging your heart the way we show it in meditation, or it is also written in the book in Soul Quest and in other books also is there. So you can do that on your own also. And you can have the stability or firmness. 33. Samyam on the light in the head results in the darshan or vision of the siddhas, the perfected beings or accomplished masters. On the head, it is referring to our pineal gland. We have also this meditation which he just mentioned, sight culturing. Now we are not using sight culturing for this purpose. To use it for this purpose takes few more steps. And we don't need all those things. We don't need all those things because Patanjali is going to tell you why we don't need all those things. But that meditation to that level, up to that level is very good for the children to develop your memory and for us to develop love, compassion and all that. 34. Samyam on the pratibha or the light of intuition within enables one to gain the knowledge of everything, omniscience. Now, intuition is talking about, is referring to a state beyond your instincts. What are our instincts? Our three chakras, three energy centers are related to instincts. The fourth one, which we call the heart center, it is called Anahata chakra. Now, Anahata chakra is the bridge between your instinct, the animalistic instinct, and the higher faculty of intuition. We can get stuck there again. If we are just talking about passion, love, then we are stuck there. But if we are practicing compassion, then our intuition is developing. So this is referring to that. Once you start practicing intuition, compassion, then your intuition will develop. And by developing intuition, you become omniscient. Now, omniscience is not something very great. It can make you very, very sad also, because you know beforehand what is going to happen in a distant part of the world. Some terrorist attack is happening somewhere, and you come to know. And then you are telling somebody, and he feels you are talking nonsense. And then 3 months later, the terrorist attack happens. I mentioned about that in one of my books. Thirty-five. Samyam on Hriday or heart as the seat of emotions and sensations makes one gain the knowledge or understanding of chitta, the mind core. Now again, he is actually, these two are related. Again, heart. As long as it is about passion, about love, that is limited to your family, friends and whatnot, just limited love, then you will never find chitta. You will never find the core of your mind. It is only when you develop compassion, your love becomes not limited but limitless, that you will know chitta. Now he is giving you hints. He is giving you very clear hints that no chitta is possible. You will have no realization of chitta. You cannot address the chitta. You cannot do anything to the chitta unless and until you are compassionate. Once you are compassionate, then you can talk to your chitta. You can make some changes there.